بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We start إن شاء الله our topic about عقيدة. And remember we last time we said that there are different ways which prove the existence of God. In fact, man, if he was left for his nature, by nature he knows that there is God and there is Creator. But we, and ulama in fact, present this and put this argument because there are some people who try to confuse people about their creator. So, and subhanAllah, this is also the argument of the Quran. The argument of the Quran, as you know, he always approach the mentality, the wisdom of man to think about this using his senses, he uses his logic, using his intelligence that Allah Azza wa Jal gave him to know about his. So last time we talked about two points or two approaches. One, the innate nature, and the calamity would purify the sense of the fitrah, which, as we said, that people when they get in trouble, under pressure, at that minute they remember and they know, and they cannot deny God because they are looking for someone so they can turn to help them in their problems, with their troubles. So this is one. Right. And then the second one, which is the Sheikh said, the second proof, this universe must have a creator. And also we discussed this last time because, as we said, any product that you can see, if you ask anyone, then he will tell you that there's somebody who produce it. And at home, for example, if you see anything which is broken, will you say that, well, this just by nature? You will go and ask, who did this? If you find, you come at your home and you find slipper or shoes outside the room, it will come to your mind and say, who is there? Because if there's any traces, that means there's somebody who left it. If there's anything which was made, then there's somebody who made it. So when you think about this universe, which is well organized, subhanAllah, look to the wisdom of Allah Azza wa Jal, well organized and smoothly, you see the relation between or among all these elements of this universe, man, animals, mountains, sun, moon, all these, they are running in very well-organized, sophisticated system that man cannot even do. Just an example. You see those who clean their kidneys because they have problems with or kidney failures. What is the size of this machine? Just think about it. It is big size. And many tubes, and the person suffer a lot just to change maybe 3 days a week. And look what Allah Azza wa Jalla provide in the body of a human being. Very tiny, small thing will purify and clean the blood every day many times. And we don't feel it about it. Who made this? It's impossible that it just come by itself. Or it's impossible that man made it. Because we can see what man was able to make. Subhanallah. This is why Allah Azza wa Jal raised this question. And this, in fact, you know, some questions, my dear brothers, in the Quran or even in the Arabic language, we call it the wondering question. That means doesn't asking to get an answer, but to turn the attention of the person to think about it and find the answer for himself. Allah Azza wa Jal said, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. Were they created by nothing? Think about it. Or were they themselves the creators? None of them. Or did they create the heavens and the earth? Nay, but they have no firm belief. Even this claim, they repeat, in fact, they don't believe it within themselves. It's just a matter of what? Argument and arrogance of man to reject the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right. I think we mentioned also the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam last week. And we said the argument with the logic, you know, about creating, you know, the sun and the sun rising and others. طيب. Reason has no choice but to admit. The Sheikh said here, but this human despair of ever discovering the stage of creation in details with regard to both the past and the future is counterbalanced by the general belief which every mind must acknowledge, voluntarily or otherwise, that no matter how long the list of cause and effect is, and whether it considers to be infinite or infinite, there should still be something else which carries in itself the cause of its existence and continued existence. So, this is the true beginning, before which there was nothing. Otherwise, all these created things would not have come into being. That means there's certain starting point. Certain starting point. That means this heaven, this earth, this creation was not here, was not there. So it was created. And it's impossible that it's come by itself in this very well-organized way. One of the arguments also of those atheists, those who say that this happened by accident. And also we talk about this, and it's impossible that accident can make any, produce any thing. And remember we talked about last week, mentioned the story of Abu Hanifa with those. طيب. This was طيب. The theory of self-generation, which means a specious argument that has been proven to be false. It's impossible, you know, that things made itself by itself. This is also, it's impossible. Otherwise, you know, it will be nice, you know, to just bring the rice and just throw it in the pot and then wait for your lunch to be ready by itself. It will not happen like this. If this is very, very simple thing, cannot happen by itself. So how about this very sophisticated system that's surrounding us? Other they said, nature is the law which governs the universe. What does it mean of nature? And this is the problem, you know, of some people. They take the word and they don't think about its meaning. This is always they said, Mother Nature. Okay. If you mean Mother Nature, that you were created to live and deal with this surrounding and environment, but to say that nature is the creator, first of all, define What do you mean by nature? What do you mean by nature? Everything here is part of this nature. Subhanallah. So another group suggests that nature is the law which governs the universe. This is the view of those who claim to have acknowledged or have knowledge and who believe that nature is the creator. They say this universe is running according to certain laws which regulate its affair down to the last detail. The events that happened in this universe happened according to this law. This is like a clock which runs accurately and precisely for a long time, running by itself with no controller. Who have a wise mind, can accept this. They talk about the clock. Have you ever seen the clock by itself set the time? At the beginning, who set the time? Who charged it? Who made it? So it's impossible by itself. So even the example they... In fact, these people are not answering the question that has been asked. Who created the universe? You said that it's running by itself. But the question is, okay, who's the one who created it? Allah Azza wa Jal, for sure, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He put in this universe a system and law. وَلَنْ تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا وَلَنْ تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَحْوِيلًا. This is the law that Allah Azza wa Jal made in this universe, in our life. The life, you know, the what we call it, the cause and the effect, this is the law. And subhanAllah, sunnatullah, or the way of Allah, or you can call it the law which Allah Azza wa Jal put, or the system that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in this life, it's not only physical. It's not only physical. In every aspect of our life. Physical, psychological, social, all this, there is law. There is system. This is why, my dear brothers, you see, why the Muslims, they built great civilization, scientific civilization. They contributed to the advancement of humanity. Why? Because they learned from the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in this universe law and system. So they exert their effort to discover this law, and from that they build this civilization. So, to find a law, in fact, or system in this universe, that doesn't, in fact, mean that universe by itself done this. In fact, this is a proof that there is a wise God who founded this system. So, look at this here. They tell us about the way in which the universe operates. And they tell us how these laws affect things. But we want to know who created this universe and who created the law that governs it. This is the question here. This is the question. Who is the one who created this? Who is the one? We have no argument that there is law. Right or not? We know that there is law. There is system. Which show the wisdom of Allah Azza wa Jal. But the question, who is the one who founded this system? The Creator Azza wa Jal. So nature does not explain anything about the universe. It itself is in need of explanation. Read this debate that could take place between the intelligent man and a doctor who is prominent in his field. Now, the Sheikh gave us example of argument here, which is interesting argument. The questioner said, why is blood red? So the doctor said, because there are red cells in the blood. The size of each cell is 1/700 of an inch. question, okay, but why are these cells red again? Doctor, because in the blood there is a substance called hemoglobin, which becomes red when it's mixed with oxygen in the heart. Again, the questioner asks, that's fair enough, but where do these cells which carry hemoglobin come from? Doctor, they are manufactured in your liver. Okay, question, wonderful. But how are all these things, the blood, cells, liver, etc., connected to one another so perfectly, and how do they each play their part with such precision? This is a question, think about it. Doctor, this is what we call the law of nature. The law of nature, this is the answer. How come? So the question said, but what do you mean by the law of nature? Doctor, what we mean by the law of nature is blind internal operation of natural and chemical forces. Can you imagine this? Any wise person will accept this. Blind? You know? A man, he cannot walk blind. If you ask somebody to just, you know, put something on his eyes and walk in the street, you will accept it? He said, do you want me to fall down or hit some rocks or so how come this very, very tiny, complicated system connected together and then she said blind? So the question said, but why do these forces always produce the same result? When you are blind and throw something, it may not do the same thing at the same different time. But this is the question. How are things regulated so that birds fly in the air, fish live in the water, and man lives in this world with all these amazing potentials and capabilities? If it's blind, it will be some confusing mixing. But that means it is not blind. It is well structured. Well structured. Doctor, don't ask me about that. My science only tells me about what happened. It does not answer the question about why it happens. This is the limit of the knowledge. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. People, they know that what's appeared to them in this worldly life. But about the hereafter, they are blind. And when you talk about the hereafter, we just give an example of the unseen. One of the unseen, which means even about God, they don't know about God. Why? Because all what they think, they just what live around them. And this is why, as we mentioned before, because the knowledge of the unseen cannot be acquired, cannot be achieved, cannot be learned through our physical world. But we need what? Huh? Revelation. Revelations to come to tell us who is God. And this is why, my dear brothers, Al-Quran give answers for the Muslim for question that people, they spend a lot or long time just to find an answer. Just one example. People ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what is the soul? What's the secret that this soul, when it's come in the body, it's make it alive? What was the answer? يسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا. سبحان الله. They ask you, O Prophet of Allah, O Muhammad, regarding the ruh, the soul, Allah Azza wa Jal is known, and he can't give an answer. But he knows, Azza wa Jal, of his knowledge and wisdom, that our mind cannot comprehend this type of knowledge. She said, tell them this is a matter of my God. And then, وَمَا أُوتِيتُمْ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. So whatever knowledge you got is nothing compared to the knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal. Very little. This is why, my dear brothers, the Muslim ulama, scholars, scientists, they didn't spend any effort to study the soul. They study everything. This is the knowledge of Allah. That means no answer will be found. While the Greek and the Western and all these scientists, they try to find what is the soul. This was the first seed in the knowledge that we, the area of study now, we call it psychology. It's started by learning about the soul. So they said, some of them, they said, well, you know, the soul, it's a type of blue crystal water, which is when it's in the body, that's we make it move. Where is this crystal, you know, red or blue water? They're nothing. They found out there's this word is nonsense. Okay, so they tried to give many answers, and then they gave up. So they said the soul is the feeling of man, and try to measure this feeling. And then they reached the conclusion with Muslims, they reached long time ago. They said, we know nothing about this, but we can study the external behavior of the person, and then we try to analyze this behavior, and this now is the purpose of psychology. Psychology now, what is it? Studying the behavior of people, and try from this behavior to find out what certain norms or laws, you know, to talk. This is psychology nowadays. And this, my dear brothers, why, you see, you will notice that the area of social studies always, it's not 100% accurate. It's not like physical. When talked about physics, chemistry, something which is touchable, then people, they can get to agreement. But when it's come to a matter of social, why? Because when we come to the explanation, everybody give a different explanation. And this, his explanations derived from where? Derived from where? From his, not, the observation is one. But this explanation, to understand what's going on, in fact, it's influenced by the person, cultural and religious background. So everybody, you know, try to give it different meaning. He give you that based on his background. So people, they will not agree in this. So, طيب. There are those who say the nature is force which created the universe. This is another argument. Now here, my dear brothers, you see, as I said, we present these different false arguments made by some people, those disbelievers, to confuse human being about his creator. طيب. Which created the universe, and that is living, hearing, seeing, wise, and powerful force. Now, they are come closer. They said, yes, well, there is a force. This force, for sure, it's here. Because if it cannot hear, how can it give you a hearing? And this force can't see. Otherwise, how come it's give you the power of seeing? What is this force? They call it force. But this force is what? It's the one who created everything. This is what we call it God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who created everything. طيب. So they said, we say to them, this is right. But your mistake is that you call this force nature. This is the... Here you are close, but the problem is with what? With labeling. You call it nature and we call it God. You call it nature, we call it God. This creative, innovative force has told us the name by which it deserves to be called, and that is Allah. Why we say that He told us? Because we have no knowledge to give Him this name, no knowledge about Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the reason for what? For the revelations and messengers and books. Because without this guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, man by himself will not reach this conclusion. What Allah Azza wa Jalla said in Surah Al-Duha? وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى. Who is this man? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم himself. Allah Azza wa Jalla said to him, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْإِيمَانِ مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ. Before the revelation come to you, O Muhammad, you don't know what does it mean, belief or books. So if this is for the chosen one, before Allah guided him, he knew nothing about this unseen. So about anybody else? Naam? So man need knowledge, and this knowledge about God, and what does he want, in fact, this cannot just come by our own personal or human methodology. But we do need connection with the one who has this knowledge, who created us, and who created this universe. Right. Those who came before them said something similar. That means, after we are talking about people of this time, now let's go to what was the argument of people before. And this means, you know, so in the Quran. Those who attribute creation to nature had a predecessor who said something very similar. These were by Zahiriya, Ad-Dahriya. Ad-Dahriya, what does it mean, Dahriya? From Dahr. Dahr means time. Dahr, means time. هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر. Dahr means a period of time. طيب. Those atheists who attributes events to a dahr time, they saw that children grow into adult, adult grow into old men, and old men die as time goes by, and night and day alternate. So they attributed life and death to time. So they said, this time is changing, people. Time is changing everything. Because of what the stages of the life. So قالوا, وقالوا ما هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا. نموت ونحيا وما يهلكنا إلا الدهر وما لهم بذلك من علم إنهم إلا يظنون. The meaning, and they say there is nothing but our life of this world, because they don't believe in the hereafter. We die and we live and nothing destroy us except الدهر, a time. Allah Azza wa Jalla answered them by saying, and they have no knowledge of it. Or they only conjecture. That means they just think. It's, you know, this is what they think, but it's not true. Now, those people attribute events to time, and these people attribute them to the nature of things. Both are equally misguided. Both. The one who say that nature is the one who create, And those who say that time is the one who play the role of changing our life, or he found this life, both are not truthful, because they were misguided. Now let's go now for number three, which is Darwin theory. And this is the problem, you know, unfortunately, of misguided, because they, you know, this theory, it took the appearance of science. And they approach people by saying, this is science, scientific, let's talk science. Let's examine this according to the Sheikh. He said, the supporter of this theory, Darwin's theory, of this theory, said, try to use it to explain the existence of living being. The theory is widespread. Many people try to spread it with good intentions. Some people, they think it is science, so they think they separate it by good intention. Not because they argue, because they love it or they like it, or but because they say this is science and we support science. Because they think that it is a scientific fact, whilst others try to spread it with bad intentions because it suits their desire. Some people, they know that it's false, but they spread it to misguide people, to misguide human beings. Right. Which is to prove religion's wrong in its description of how man was created. All their purpose is to destroy religion. This is their purpose. Even they know that this, in fact, theory is not correct, it's not fact, it's just imagination, even though they insist and try to separate it just because they are anti-religion. This is their. Those who seek to undermine religion find evidence in science to support their stance and deceive people. Okay. What does this theory say? Now let's go and examine this theory. This theory claims that the origin of all creations was small organisms which developed from water. Then their environment changed them until new characteristics emerged in this life form, and these characteristics over millions of years led to the development of more advanced characteristics which changed that primitive creation into a superior life form. This development of the characteristics caused by the environment and evolution continue until it arrived at the appearance of man. This is there. But now, people who lived before us, and we lived, what happened in the nature of man from that time till this time? The ape is still ape. The monkey is still monkey. Right or not? Have you ever seen monkey? You know that change? They have civilization. They have building. They have language. The animals are still as they say. Is there a difference between Arabian cat or American cat or Filipino cat or Indian cat? Do they speak different meow? No. So for all these years, people telling you that the same thing has happened. Why they didn't change by all this time? Just think about it. According to this theory, that means we reach something in you. Subhanallah. The basis of this theory now, this theory is based on what was noted during excavations carried out during Darwin's time. Look, they discovered that the more ancient levels contained primitive life forms, and the levels above them contained progressively more developed life forms. Darwin said, these more highly developed animals came about as a result of evolution from earlier primitive life form. This is a matter of theory, opinion. There's no proof. It's just a matter of opinion. Second, It was also based on what was known at Darwin's time about the resemblance of the embryo of different animals at the early stage of development. They said, look, if you look at the human embryo and the embryo of many of the creation, at the beginning, when they come from the egg, almost they took the same, had the same shape. They said, you see, they were the same. Does this prove anything? It proves only one thing, that the Creator is one, because they started them, and then to show you His power, by this is why Allah Azza wa Jal said, ثُمَّ أَنْشَأْنَاهُ خَلْقًا آخَرٌ فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal, when talk about the stage of embryo, they give you the same stage, and then said, and then we made him a different thing, a different creation. Which could give the impression that the origin of all animals is the same, as their embryos appear to be the same. And the evolution happened on Earth along the same lines as the development of embryo is the womb living being. So this is another argument. The third one is, it was also based on the existence of the vermal form expended in human beings, which helps digesting plant matter. But it no longer has any function in man. They said there are certain things in man, but now it doesn't have any function. Like, for example, you know, the priest, they said, what is this? Man doesn't need this. It's not like a woman, they need it. So they said this disappeared because of the evolution. This is their argument. طيب. So that would explain the process of evolution. How does he explain this? First, he said, natural selection. Destructive factors kill off the weaker specimens and leave the stronger specimens. It's a matter of challenge and fighting. And this is what they claim. Sexual selection. This has to do with preference of both male and female to mate with strong specimen. But now let's talk about, just for to answer or to respond to this. The Sheikh said, archaeology is not precise science, and no one can claim that he has carried out a complete survey of all layers of the earth. The question is, what is the scientific methodology that you follow to reach this conclusion? We know that whenever somebody comes with any results, okay, we ask him, what was your methodology? How did you do this study? How did you carry this investigation? People, they will not accept any outcome, right or not. If somebody come to a result for you, say, how did you find it? What's the way that you follow? What the steps? So this is not science, including those beneath mountains and ocean, and that he did not find anything new that would challenge previously held accept. Even if we suppose that the statement of this branch of science are proven to be true, the fact that there were at first primitive life forms, which were then superseded by more advanced creatures, does not prove that the advance of life form developed from their primitive counterparts. Even though it will not prove anything. Maybe it's a matter of what? Of stage that went through, and that doesn't mean by itself that Allah Azza wa Jal made it this way and put this system. All that this proof is the order of their existence, which may simply be a reflection of change in environment which supported different life forms at different times. Recent discovery in the field for the put the age of man at 10 million years. They said man in this world 10 million years. Who can prove this? What's the proof that it's 10 million? Is another question. If we talk about, just if you look at the time from Isa alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only 600 years. From the time of Musa to, they said, around 2,000 years. So there's no proof about this time. The Sheikh mentioned comments of Dr. Mustafa Shakir. So Mustafa Shakir is one of the scientists who wrote a book called A Man in the Mirror, or translate this. He said, we talk about Neanderthal man. You know, they found some Neanderthal man, like some men or some bodies, which was covered by snow or by in some area which is cold, and they took this and tried to find or make from that this big story, which was not. Anyway, I will leave this for you to read because it's give a lot of detail. But here, let's go to some of the answer. This theory, according to the Sheikh, said, is not supported by reality. As conclusion, this theory does not support by reality. If this theory were true, we would see many animals and people coming into existence through evolution, as we mentioned. Many now a new race of man, a new race of animals exist. And people now, for how many, for 1,000 years, they have writing, right or not? They didn't write, or they told us that the form of man was different from the form that we know it these days. Even if you go in ancient, for example, Egypt, look to the pictures. It is man is the man, the same as he was. So there is no evolution. Not only through reproduction, even if evolution needs a long time, this does not mean that we would not see monkeys changing into man, one group after another. They said it's changed, okay. And one group, they change. How about the rest? Why they stay as apes, as monkeys? Among them, the superior. Why they did not transform to man again, as it's happened for previous monkeys? So even the logic does not accept. Even if we accept the natural circumstances and natural selection turn a monkey into man, for example, we cannot accept that these circumstances would also dictate that there would be a woman to accompany this man, that they could reproduce and there would be a balance between men and women. Okay, what changed to a man? Okay, who made them male and female? Allah Azza wa Jalla created man and woman from one soul. Nafs wahid created them. The ability to adopt which we see in creations, such as the chameleon, which change into its colors according to where it is an ability which is inherent in the formation of that creator. You know, sometimes they say, look now, for example, there is some type of frog. I don't know if you see this or not.
Yeah.
Huh? If you put it in any surface, if it was black, it will turn to black. Have you put it in a green? Put it not to green. Have you put it in a red? This doesn't mean that it's adopt this. It was already built in its system. Subhanallah, Allah Azza wa Jal gave the creation different way to defend itself, to protect itself. And some of these ways is what? Huh? To hide. Either in a color. This is why it changed its color. So it will not be noted by its enemies. Subhanallah, even there are some insects. If you see it in the tree, you think it's a part of the tree. It's a plant. So all these show you the wisdom and the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And I give an example here. Frogs are distinguished from man in their ability to live on the land and in the water. Birds are distinguished from man by their ability to fly and move rapidly without the aid of machine. A dog's nose is far more sensitive than that of a human. So, is a dog's nose more advanced than a human nose? We say this advancement by superiority, right? Does this mean that more advanced than? No. But because it was built, it was created in this way. What time? How long time we have? Huh? Okay, because we need some time for talk. Huh? For Adhan? 10 minutes for Adhan? Now let's end just with this. The attitude of natural scientists toward this theory. Those who support this theory want to support the freedom of thought which the church opposed and resisted. So this is when you know the reason, you will not wonder where did all this come from. Because there had been, you see, the environment where this type of theories and science come, it's a matter or a result of what? Of control, there's some controversy between the church, which banned all ways of thinking and science, and those scientists who want the freedom to do all types of research. This problem, my dear brothers, it's not, you know, for the Muslim, because in Islam, the Quran, the Sunnah, encourage man to what? To search, to study, to investigate, to discover, and look to the Quran always. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ يَعْلَمُونَ يَتَدَبَّرُونَ. All these words that encourage man to think, to discover, to search. قُلْ سِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Go in the land. Look around you. وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. They think about the creation, the heaven and the earth. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا. So the Quran, the Sunnah, Islam, never ever stand against science or scientists. But when you talk about the church, at that time, the Middle Ages, what they call it, the Dark Ages, unfortunately, some Muslim, they said Dark Ages. Yes, it is Dark Ages for them, but for Muslim at that time is what? The Golden Ages. The Golden Ages. It's a Islamic civilization. At that time, this what was the controversy between scientists and the church. And this what, you know, moved many of those claimed to be science to make like a revolution against the church and religion. So they support anything which contradict with what? With the religious teaching. If it was okay and understandable for them, but we cannot accept it from a Muslim, because the Muslim, he knows that there is no contradiction between Islam and science. طيب. Inshallah, we'll talk about this in detail in our next meeting to so that all this type of theory is not in fact based on knowledge of the real science, but mostly it's like a series, it's a matter of thought that carried by some people, and they give it the image of science and motivated by different motives. And inshallah we'll move to the fiqh class. Jazakumullah.